This is Chaudhary Mahmood Anwar. Welcome to my lecture. Today I will explain how to test the predictive validity of a new construct. Previously, I have explained the concept of predictive validity in my confirmatory composite analysis video. The predictive validity was a step in the confirmatory composite analysis. But in this video, I will explain in detail how to perform the statistical analysis to test predictive validity of new construct. So what is predictive validity? It's in fact our criterion-related validity. In criterion-related validity, we check the performance of our operationalization against some criterion. We usually make a prediction about how the operationalization will perform based on our theory of the construct. So remember, in predictive validity, your theory of the construct is much important. The researcher is primarily interested in some criterion which he wishes to predict. He administers the test, obtains an independent criterion measure on the same subjects, and finally he conducts statistical analysis. So what would be the criterion? Of course, it depends on your theory. Psychologists and organizational researchers usually correlate new traits with external criterion or independent index, such as psychophysiological functioning, job performance, or employee behavior to establish predictive validity of new traits. So what statistical method you will use to test the predictive validity? If your study is following the prototypical epistemological processes, then you will use correlation analysis. And if your study is using ontological processes, then you will use regression analysis. Here are some examples. Hoffman et al. 2015 tested the predictive validity of their construct, which is assessment center ratings, by testing the bivariate relationship between assessment center rating and job performance. Similarly, Shen et al. 2014 tested bivariate relationship between adult playfulness trait and playfulness behavior to test the predictive validity for adult playfulness trait. Anwar 2020 tested bivariate relationship between innovative esteem and innovative job performance. He also tested whether innovative esteem predicts innovative job performance or not, because his study applied ontological processes as well. We can test the predictive validity by using SPSS, AMS, or SmartPLS. In this example, I will show you how to test predictive validity in SPSS. So this is our SPSS data file. This is the variable view. This is data view. We have 100 responses. And we will test the predictive validity for innovativeness-based self-esteem. We have two variables, innovativeness-based self-esteem and innovative performance of employees. So first, we will test the predictive validity by using prototypical epistemological processes. Go to Analyze, Correlate, Bivariate. Here the variables are innovativeness-based self-esteem and innovative performance. Click OK. So this is the result. We can see that the correlation between innovativeness-based self-esteem and innovative performance is 0.779 and it's significant at 0.01. Therefore, we will conclude that innovativeness-based self-esteem has a very nice correlation with innovative performance. Therefore, the predictive validity of innovativeness-based self-esteem has been established. Now I will test by using ontological processes. Go to Analyze, Regression, Linear. Here put innovative performance as a dependent variable and innovativeness-based self-esteem as an independent variable. We don't need anything else. Just check statistics, model fit, and estimates are clicked. Continue. Click OK. So this is the result. Now we can see that our overall regression model is significant with F is 151.559 and significance level is 0.001. Here you can see that innovativeness-based self-esteem has an unstandardized coefficient of 0.52, which is significant at 0.001. Therefore, the ontological evidence of predictive validity of innovativeness-based self-esteem has been established. If the correlation is not significant or very low correlation, or the regression results are not significant, then you will say that your new construct fails to reflect an evidence of predictive validity. So this is how you will test your predictive validity in SPSS. You can also use AMOS or SmartPLS. If you are interested to use SmartPLS, simply you will draw a simple path diagram in which you will place your new construct or trait as independent variable, and your innovative performance or your performance or your satisfaction variable as an criteria, whatever variable you have decided to include as a criteria in your model. So you will simply run the path analysis in SmartPLS and you will check the path coefficient between your new construct and criterion. If path coefficient is significant, then you can claim that you have significant evidence of predictive validity of your new construct. And if you want to test the predictive validity in AMOS, simply you will create this type of model. This is a path model in AMOS. You will place your new construct as independent variable and criterion as dependent variable. And you will run the path model and check what is the beta coefficient for this path model. Here it's 0.34, which is significant. Therefore, an evidence of predictive validity of new construct will be established. This is how you will test the predictive validity of new construct. I have told you clearly what to do if you are using prototypical epistemological processes and what to do if you are using the ontological processes. Thank you very much for watching this video.
Are you tired of rejection of your academic scholarship? Submit your research to International Journal of Management, Economics and Social Sciences. With us, you will experience a reputable publishing platform that will guarantee high-quality peer review. Our unique mentorship program enables you to develop your research to increase the chances of publication. Our editors are eminent researchers who will provide the much-needed impetus for your academic works. Visit www.ijmes.com and get your work published.